Hey everyone, Tyler, can we zoom the camera in, please? That's a little much, don't you think? That's better. Welcome to My Zoo Tokens. Now, I know it's been a while since our last retro review, so this week, I'm here in Spiral Mountain to review a classic Nintendo 64 game, and arguably one of the best on the console, Banjo-Kazooie. For those of you who missed out on this one, Banjo is a dim-witted honey bear who lives in Spiral Mountain with Kazooie, a wisecracking red-crested beagle who lives in his backpack, and his little sister, Tootie. The evil witch, Gruntilda, lives in her nearby lair, the entrance of which consists of her giant ugly mug carved into the mountainside. Seriously, Banjo, you never noticed that? Okay, fine, pay no attention to the gaping plot hole behind the curtain. One day, Grunty decides she's sick of being ugly and kidnaps Tootie to steal her beauty. And Banjo and Kazooie set off to rescue her. Being an N64-era platform game, Banjo-Kazooie involves finding a large amount of identical objects. Instead of stars, however, Banjo and Kazooie are collecting golden jigsaw pieces called jiggies. Bet you didn't know that song was about this game, huh? Anyway, to enter any of the game's 9 worlds, you will need to find the world portrait, then use jiggies to complete the portrait puzzle so the door will open. Every world has 10 jiggies to collect, but sometimes you won't be able to get them all right away. Enter Bottles the Mole. You'll have to find his molehills throughout the worlds to learn new moves to get more jiggies. To progress to Grunty's lair, however, which serves as the overworld, you'll need to collect musical notes. There's 100 on each world, and you'll need a little over 800 notes to even get to Grunty. There's 900 total. Finally, in 5 of the 9 worlds, you can find the hut of the skullfish shaman Mumbo Jumbo, who will turn you into a series of critters in order to collect jiggies. Save for the crocodile, however, Banjo has no attacks in these forms, so caution is required. As usual, Rare really outdid themselves on this part. The N64 does not have the best sound processor by today's standards. Mid-Eyes were the wave of the future back then. Sound file joke, sorry. Anyway, the music in Banjo-Kazooie is so good that I was convinced as a kid that it was done with real instruments. I was 10, don't judge me. The game's catchy tunes and silly sound effects make it fun to play with the sound turned up. Even though it doesn't utilize the full-blown speech engine later seen in Rare's Conker's Bad Fur Day, and the strange sound effects used in place of character voices can get a little repetitive, the music is redemptive enough to let that slide. You'll be walking away from this one humming too. Overall, Banjo-Kazooie is a great game with tons of stuff going for it. Unfortunately, there's not a lot of character originality or development. I mean, Gruntilda is 3 flying monkeys away from being the Wicked Witch of the West, and Kazooie herself isn't even really that likable because she's so nasty to everyone. Then again, you try living in a backpack for a few years and see if you don't develop an attitude problem. Second, the final boss fight with Gruntilda is a gigantic boil on Grunty's gigantic ass. It's a pain to unlock, and it's a 5-part death fest. The battle itself may be a bitch, but the hag herself is certainly not the brightest twinkly in the box, you know, evil plan-wise. On the upside, even though the items are numerous, they're about as easy to find as the contradictions in a Fox News piece. And the difficulty curve is so steady that you have time to dig around in the first world, then raise some honey bear hell against your foes in the ninth. Also, the game show at the end of the lair is pretty fun, but it just proves my theory about Grunty. She's an idiot. Harry Potter could have killed them 2 hours ago, and she makes them play a round of Trivial Pursuit. Okay, over a boiling lava pit, but still, Avada Kedavra, Grunty. Third, the dialogue is pretty funny, if a bit cutesy at times. There's a little bit of scatological humor, especially involving Mad Monster Mansion's talking toilet Logo, but it's all handled very tastefully. That is, until you have to go down Logo's mouth to get a jiggy, then they've lost all pretense. My Two Tokens gives Banjo-Kazooie for the Nintendo 64 8.5 stars out of 10. Even though there were a few story issues, Banjo-Kazooie is a great game, Banjo-Chooie was even better, and together they are easily 2 of the best games on the N64. I honestly don't see any way Rare could screw up this amazing series. Oh, right. Damn. Well, for more reviews, please visit our website, mytwotokens.com. Head over to our forums or our Twitter feed for more info on My Two Tokens. And by the way, we're on Facebook now, so feel free to like our group. Thanks for watching My Two Tokens. See you next time!